Well, you know, this is just kind of what the Mavericks are looking at with their opportunities, but not going to matter because they're going to end up doing something crazy and pull off like a Damian Lillard trade. You never know.
Oh, I would love that.
Yeah. You know, everyone wanting to jump on that would point to the fact that as far as big fish go, like Levine, Zach Levine was a name tossed around a lot.
Let's jump on that right quick. Let me jump on that right quick. I don't think Zach LaVine is the answer. Okay. I like Zach LaVine's talent. He's not getting Dallas over the hump, period. Yeah. Not my opinion. Now, if you got a Damian Lillard, I would change my tune because Lillard already showed you he had McCollum on his team. McCollum mm-hmm. is a dog. And you saw when he went over, McCollum is a dog. And you saw, I like how Lillard adjusted his game for McCollum because McCollum is a scorer.
Yeah.
And they adjusted their game and they were able to play with each other. That's why I would want a Dame Lillard more than a Zach LaVine, because I feel like Lillard will alter his game for Luka.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? He would understand this is Luka's team, not mine. And he would still come with it, but I feel like he would be a great option because Lillard is a team player. I don't know if Zach LaVine is that guy. In my opinion, I don't feel like Zach LaVine is a team player. And I feel like if he came over with Luka, I don't feel like that would work.
Yeah.
Just my opinion. I feel like it would not work and I don't want it. And I don't want Zach LaVine coming to Dallas. Just right. Me.
Yeah. No, when I look at the possibility of like Damian Lillard, like where it's fun to entertain in any capacity is where you look at it and you're like, well, he was very outspoken and, or rather his representation was very outspoken that he wanted Jason Kidd as his head coach in Portland and then get him. He came to Dallas. And they got Chauncey Billups. Their season was a disaster and really close with Nico Harrison. Like his iconic shot, game five over OKC, the deep, deep three in Paul George's face that got played mm-hmm. a million times.
Mm-hmm.
Who's the first person he runs to on the sideline? Nico Harrison. That's the first guy he ran over to dap up. He's tight with Nico. He wanted Jason Kidd as the coach. And you know, I think other guys like Jared Dudley on its staff, highly respected. I never necessarily got the appeal of Dudley, but see all these other guys around the league and it's like, okay, well, he's at least got
they love
respect.
Him.
Yeah, he's got their respect. So,
right.
If you look at it that way, maybe you could see a scenario. But here's the thing with Dame is like, I can't fathom a situation. Not that I can't see Luka sharing the load, as long as I think Luka would still have to be the top guy, especially Dame being 32,
coming right.
off a couple banged up years, especially this right. past year with the, I think, ab muscle tear he had.
Mm-hmm.
But it's like, well, if you're keeping Brunson, you're going to have Brunson, Luka, and Dame. First of all, how are you going to make that work financially?
Right, because right.
I think Dame's on a supermax.
Yeah, and he's going to cost a lot of money.
Ooh, a lot.
It's like, he ain't coming cheap.
No, so it's like, how are you making that work financially? And then how does right. the on-court thing work where you got three guys that are ball dominant? Now, right. Jalen obviously is willing to defer to Luka, and he gets that, mm-hmm. which is why I think Jalen is a great option moving forward and why I say, like, even though I've had some reservations about him at times, if nothing else, I know his willingness to fit into the role that he's given
right.
in this case. He's not going to overstep his bounds. You're not going right. to see a situation
he
where
he knows
he's like,
Luka's the man.
Right. He's not going to go, eh, this is my night. And then just right. kind of go out into business right, for himself.
Right.
So
right.
That's the fun thing. The Dame thing, you know, I started kind of thinking through some of those points and everything. And I was like, there's a conspiracy theory there for sure. But It doesn't necessarily fit. I think in the realm of reality, we're probably looking at these options we just talked about with the six shooter, the mid levels and the vet minimum.
Yeah, probably. I mean, like you said, Dame's going to cost a lot of money. I still think in my heart, just me, I feel like Dame will take that second role to Luka because he understands what Luka is. And he understands. And if he talks about, I want to play for Jason Kidd. Then if you want to play for Jason Kidd should let you know that Luka's the man. So yeah. you need to change your role up. But so I think it, in my opinion, I think Kidd can figure it out. It's just that money situation.
Yeah.
Dame going to cost too much money. And I think that's going to be the deciding factor right there. If they were to look at it, he going to cost too much money. But I think it could fit and it could work because Jalen Brunson, to me, I think he's an ultimate team player. Mm-hmm. And I feel like he could say, okay, if I'm coming off the bench, you got Dame, I got paid.
Right.
I want to win. You know what I'm saying? I don't feel like Brunson is that guy that's going to ruffle feathers. That's why I feel like it could work. But I just feel like on the financial tip, what we were talking about earlier, DDP, mm-hmm. with the veteran minimum, Dame is just going to outprice us.
Yeah,
to be looked at. He's just going to cost too much money.
Right. Yeah. And on the Jalen note, real quick, it's like I could see a scenario wherein, like, yeah, I do agree that he puts the team first. He especially likes these guys. And I think he does understand the Mavericks have kind of given him the time and helped him develop. I get that. But I also think if you were to relegate him back to the bench because you acquired somehow, some way, another star player ahead of him, I think he would take that as disrespect. It's like, yeah, you paid me, but
now
you
also
reduced my role, and now I'm playing third fiddle. And like, to be clear, that might be the case anyway for what Dallas needs to really compete is for Jalen to be the third guy. But it's different if you're the third guy, but you're in the starting line. Right. Even Harden, you don't have a Manu Ginobili. You just don't. James Harden in OKC blew up a potential dynasty, I should say, because he didn't like coming off the bench, even though he wanted to
be the man.
Right. And he was offered the ability to start. They said, hey, we can start you. We'll still play the minutes, but, you know, we can't give you like the max you can get. And I think it was like a difference of like $5 or $8 million total. Difference between what the max would be and what they offered. He said, no, I want the max. And it's like, dude, you're 23. You have so much time to get all that money.
But DDP, why you're saying that though, DDP, that just tells you what Harden is as a player and a person. I don't disrespect you as a person, Harden, but that just shows what you're about. You're just about the bread and you're about me. That's why you don't win.
Right.
And I don't care what anybody says. These players nowadays, I get frustrated with because I ain't going to lie. I'm a little old school. I look young, but I'm a little old school. So I seen those guys in the 80s, 90s. So I know it's different. It's a different day and age with the contracts and things or whatever. But, you know, these guys have a losing season or two losing seasons in a row, DDP, and they want to change teams. Yeah. And they want to go jump ship. And you're already talking about Kyrie Irving, like, oh, I don't know if I'm going to stay with the Nets. And then Katie, all right, if he ain't going to stay, I ain't going to stay.
Well, shit,
like,
look at Harden. He forced his way out of Houston to
and you Brooklyn. Didn't win. He
played with him for like, he played like 15 or 16 games with KD and Kyrie, forced his way out again to go to
Philly, and you ain't winning.
And now the only reason he probably stays there is because they're dumb enough to keep paying him. They feel like,
and well, that's stupid.
Shit. Yeah.
No, and that's stupid. Y'all are dumb. If y'all pay him a max deal, y'all crazy.
Yeah,
because that just shows you. And they will, because these NBA teams or whatever feel like they're forced, their hands are forced to do that, DDP. And you know, like I know it, Harden is not that player anymore. No,
he's been done for 3 years.
Right. He just proved it again. He's not that guy anymore. That dribble between your legs 3 or 4 times in a row. Nobody's going for that anymore. He's not the same player. And it's just crazy. Like the Ben Simmons, these guys just jump ship thinking they're going to go to a team and win a championship. It don't work like that, man. I don't care what you say.
Yeah. It's incredibly difficult to do when you don't take care of your own physical health, like getting plenty of rest and not going out clubbing all the time and shit.
Right.
Staying up all night. Like that's what Harden does. Like Harden likes the party lifestyle. He likes the superstar thing. That's part of why he didn't like Brooklyn was they didn't have as many strip clubs, apparently, which that was something I would not have guessed. But apparently that was a big sticking point for him, that Houston, his jersey was retired in like every Houston strip club. The dude would go in there and drop $1 million a night and shit. Like,
see what I'm saying, man? Like these new age players, DDP. I just don't deal with them.
Yeah.
They're some new age players. And that's what I love about Luka. You understand what I'm saying? That's what I love about Luka, because I still feel like he has the purity of the game. Mm-hmm. He hasn't been poisoned by this other stuff. And what you talked about in the very beginning of the show, I totally agree, where Luka is about trying to win championships.
Yep.
He ain't caring about nothing else.
No, he doesn't care about his MVPs. Money.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? He want championships, and that's what it means to him. So for them to get to the Western Conference Finals, like you said, DDP, that calmed him down. You know what I mean? That like, okay, we got to the Western Conference Finals. I'm feeling good about that. You know what I mean? Because if they would have had another early exit, Luka been pissed.
Yeah.
I think Luka would have been talking in the media. Luka would have been saying stuff because Luka ain't about losing.
Right.
Period.
The run they went on essentially turned him in, at least for the time being, the kind of Joel Embiid.
Yeah.
Joel Embiid, where he's just like, trust the process.
Mm-hmm.
They've been telling me this was going to work, and now here it is. All of a sudden, we go on a deep playoff run. Okay, I see things are working. I see it coming together. Okay,
I'll chill.
I just got paid. Yes. All right. I'm gonna
chill for a few years.
Yeah. And a few years, man, that time moves so fast now. Like, he could be in a completely different headspace by this time next year, for all we know. It could be as early as 2 years. DDP,
but you know Luka, DDP. Luka only going to do it for a couple of years.
Yeah.
If they regress, like you said.
Yeah.
If they go to the finals and lose a first round exit.
Yeah.
Luka going to go off.